You know, the best-selling thriller from Da Vinci Code author Dan Brown is the new one is called, what is it called? Lost Symbol, right?
Lost Symbol.
Set in the nation's capital, and it's centered on the world's oldest and largest fraternity.
Brown's book has renewed interest in the Freemasons, and as Elaine Quijano tells us this morning, it is a secret society that is still very well represented in Washington.
John and Kieran, for all the conspiracy theories about Freemasons, this much is true. They can still be found at the highest levels of American government.
From the Capitol to the White House, Freemasons throughout history have freely roamed the halls of power in Washington. Nine of the men who signed the Declaration of Independence were Freemasons, as were more than a dozen U.S. presidents, including George Washington, who famously laid the cornerstone of the Capitol building clad in his ceremonial Masonic apron. These days, Masons can still be found in powerful government positions. Masonic historian Arturo de Hoyos.
We have egalitarian ideas. We believe that people should rule themselves, that they should elect their own leaders, that they should be governed by constitutions, have separations of power.
Senator Chuck Grassley's a Mason, so is Senator John Tester. But getting someone to chat about it can sometimes be tricky.
I'm doing health care.
Senator Mike Enzi didn't break stride while explaining why he's part of the secretive society.
It's a brotherhood built on constructing good men.
Yet behind these closed doors,
I became a Mason in my local lodge in Beckley, West Virginia.
Secrets revealed.
This was this 32nd degree.
Congressman Nick Rahal, a Mason for almost four decades, decoded Masonry's most prolific symbol.
You may see the compass and the square as symbols of Masonic training. We live by the square. We're upright individuals.
The congressman describes Masonry as a fraternity. He says his mentor and fellow Mason, West Virginia Senator Robert Byrd, nominated him for membership. As a 33rd degree Mason, the highest level in the Scottish Rite of Freemasonry, Congressman Rahal acknowledges there are a lot of secrets and codes, but he says they're not sinister.
So are you trying to rule the world?
Well, let's say no. But if we were, would I tell you? No.
Congressman Rahal says Freemasonry today is more of a social organization, and despite the prominent positions of some members, is not a forum to discuss power politics. John, Kieran?
Elaine Quijano this morning. Elaine, thanks. We should also mention, too, that they raise millions upon millions of dollars every year for charities. So.
See that? And he wouldn't tell you if they rule the world.
I like that.